This video reviews how to access and maintain your personal profile in ERA Commons. The personal profile in ERA Commons is the central repository of information for all Commons registered users, including reviewers. It is designed so that individual users manage their own profile information and keep it accurate and up to date. This information is used to automatically populate certain fields in IAR and peer review. If a reviewer is also a principal investigator, PI, and they realize they have one or more personal profiles in ERA Commons, they should contact the ERA service desk to collapse the profiles. Principal investigators and/or reviewers should only have one profile that follows them through their career. Duplicate profiles can cause confusion about their status as a reviewer. To access the personal profile, log into ERA Commons and select the Personal Profile tab from the menu. The sections that you see in the personal profile depend on the roles you have in ERA Commons. Click on an individual category to view that category, or click View All to expand the detail information for all the categories of the profile. Click Edit to update the information in a category. Make sure to save your changes when done. And this is important: note the information at the top of the personal profile summary. Any changes you make to the profile will not be saved until you have provided all the required information. The system shows you what information you are missing, with information at the top of the page, in individual categories, and in the summary section along the left side. So, it is critical that you provide at least all the required information. Let's look at the first category by clicking the Edit button along the right side of the Name and ID section. Here, enter and maintain your name, account-related email address, and grants-related contact information. Identification information is used to correctly identify this as your profile, if there should ever be a need to do so. Citizenship status is required for trainee and career development awards. The email address for account-related communications will be used if you need to reset your password. Here is a neat feature. Check the Replace Other Email Addresses checkbox if you want to replace the email addresses you have provided in the awards-related communication and reviewer communication address fields with this email address. A confirmation message will pop up asking if you want to proceed. You should consider the consequences of using the Replace Other Email Addresses checkbox. Using this option means you will only have one account to check for those types of communications. However, make sure it is an email address you will have access to. If you choose an address provided by your organization, you may lose access to that account if you leave. Be sure you update this information with an email address you have access to before you ever leave the organization or change the default address. Moving on to the demographics section. The information you provide in the demographics section is used only for aggregate statistical reporting. The sex, race and ethnicity, and disability information are confidential and protected by the Privacy Act. But the information is critical to NIH as part of the Biomedical Research Workforce Initiative, whose vision is to build a robust and diverse research workforce. However, if you don't wish to disclose this information, select Do Not Wish to Provide. In the Employment section, enter and maintain your past and present research and professional employment information. As an internet-assisted reviewer, you must maintain at least 3 years of employment information. This information is vital for scientific review officers to determine if you, as a reviewer, have any conflict with any of the grant applications you will be reviewing. Remember to update your employment information as is appropriate. If you're moving to a new job, you will need to use the Add a New Job button and complete all the required fields, particularly the start date. be sure to save all your changes before exiting the screen. If you are adding a new job, that could also mean you are leaving an old job. Make sure you update the information for the job you are leaving. You will click the Leave Job button in the Employment section. Then add the end date in the field provided. Click the Leave Job button just below the date field. And make sure to save all your changes before exiting the screen. In the Reviewer Information section, view, add, and/or update your preferred reviewer contact information for review meetings. Some pointers on entering international addresses. Only a United States address requires content in the state field. The country field has the type ahead feature. As soon as you start typing a country, a list of countries appears. If you select another country, the state field becomes disabled and is no longer required. The zip code field is free text, and the system does not check what is entered. If your work address is your preferred contact, and there is more than one, select the preferred address from the drop-down list. If it is a new work address, make sure your employment section has been updated. You can also use your home or another address as the contact information. Home address should be the same as the one you use for filing your federal income tax. Click on the Secure Payment Registration System, SPRS, link. Fill out the required financial information in SPRS to receive your honoraria and reimbursement for study section services. See the related video on reviewers. Getting reimbursement of expenses and honoraria. Let's take a quick look at the Education section. In the Education section, you can add, edit, or delete your degree. It is important to remember that none of the information you entered will be saved until all the required fields are completed. If you leave the personal profile with required fields incomplete, none of the data you have entered will be saved. When you have completed all the required fields, select the Save All button at the top of the profile screen to save the changes. A number of resources are available to you about the personal profile. We very much appreciate your service as a reviewer. If you still have questions about how to get started with IAR, contact your SRO or the ERA service desk. Thanks for watching.